Now I give the floor to Mr. Gheorghe Tsereteli, who is a member of the Parliament of Georgia and Vice President of the OSCE Parliamentary Assembly.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker, Your Excellency, distinguished participants, dear colleagues. Let me firstly express my gratitude to be invited for this very important and timely conference. And I'd like to say that we all highly value the initiatives of the Kazakhstan, and especially of the President of the Republic of Kazakhstan, Mr. Nursultan Nazarbayev, on a different initiatives, very important ones. I'd like to mention creation of a UN Global Anti-Terrorist Coalition under the UN auspices and adoption of a UN comprehensive document for countering terrorism. Manifesto of the World 21st Century, this unique political document offers guiding principles for the world community to preventing dramatic developments and brutal conflicts. I would like to underline the special role of the Congress of the Leaders of World and Traditional Religions, which is very strong and effective, efficient platform of the global interfaith dialogue. We are grateful to the President of the Senate, Mr. Tokayev, for his leadership and important efforts to strengthen this format of cooperation. Ladies and gentlemen, it is clear that religiosity increased worldwide and that the religion should play a significant role in our efforts to achieve peace globally. Religion is important in inspiring and motivating our societies. It's touching the human spirit and strengthening capacity to love, to forgive, and to create. But religious-based terrorism is threatening international stability and peace and lead our communities to deep distress. Combat against terrorism is crucial, but it's also necessary for the states to reevaluate why they become the targets of terrorist attacks. And if the option to fight religious terrorists by violence, this will only result in more conflicts and more severe social stress. Nevertheless, terrorism eradication is highly complex and hard task. Accordingly, countries involved in this process need to find the key causes of religious-based terrorism. We cannot gain a victory only by military means against terrorists. We must eradicate this disease via its social, economical, political, cultural, religious, and ideological ways. Distinguished participants, respect for freedom of religion or belief in the context of counterterrorist approaches is another greatest challenge today. When speaking about the right to freedom of religion, it implies respecting the diversities in society, to incorporate them into the national cultural space, and to defend the rule of law without discrimination. Protection of freedom of religion or belief also means to ensure that citizens are protected against violence committed in the name of religion, and that such acts are condemned and prosecuted. Gaps are created by the failure of respect of human rights, build accountable institutions, promote political participation, and ensure opportunity. The wider the gaps, the greater the openings for violent extremists. This is a UN Secretary General's very precise assessment. Unfortunately, the frequency scale of violence and global reach of religious terrorism has increased. Religious doctrine is a tool of mobilization or a justification for terrorism rather than a direct cause. Religiosity itself is not a cause of political radicalism. Scientists surveyed almost 2,000 different conflicts and found that less than 10% involved religion. Such type of violence can only be the result of the intention of the aggressors to attack religion itself. Consequently, every attack made in name of religion on innocent people is actually an attack made against religion. Terrorists continue to challenge security of the OSCE region and OSCE participating states and counterterrorism remains high on the OSCE agenda. So I'm, as a Vice President of the Assembly, also like to say that there are different challenges, and there are new challenges. With the expansion of the European Union and the acute immigration problem, there are new challenges. The problem of minority inclusion is becoming more vital and increasingly multi-ethnic and multicultural in multicultural societies. The OSCE and its Parliamentary Assembly provides a unique platform for dialogue among counterterrorism policy experts and practitioners to promote good practices and networking, to raise awareness and to build capacity among governments, civil society and the private sector. And I'd like to thank our Kazakh colleagues, delegation of Kazakhstan, and again Mr. Tokayev for their great contribution in this process. So the issue of religious tolerance and dialogue has never been more important than today. Georgia, my country, is a part of this broad dialogue. Georgia can be proud, as many countries over the world, of its traditional religious tolerance, which makes it in many ways a model for peaceful coexistence between religions. Religion should bring us together and not divide us. Generations of people find strength, comfort, and hope in their faith, and religion should be a strong force for peace, mercy, forgiveness, and tolerance. Political leaders from governments or parliamentarians or parliaments play a key role in achieving national consensus against terrorism in all its forms and manifestation, in providing solidarity and support to victims of terrorism. To combine efforts and cooperation with religious leaders to combat terrorism and extremism will be easier to promote freedom, peace, and mutual respect. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you very much. Thank you.